So this talk is about the algebraic cryptanalysis of the algebraic surface cryptosystem, which was proposed last year at PKC 2009, and this is a joint work with Jean-Charles Fogère. So the general context of this work is multivariate cryptography, which constitutes a large family of cryptosystems whose security relies on the difficulty of solving some hard algebraic problems. So usually, the algebraic problem under consideration is the problem of solving a large system of multivariate equations. So for instance, it's HFE or UOV. So this is from the design viewpoint. And from the cryptanalysis viewpoint, the main tool is algebraic cryptanalysis, which is a general framework which permits to evaluate the security of different cryptographic primitives by using algebraic tools or tools from computer algebra. So in this talk, we'll focus on the algebraic surface cryptosystem, which is based on another difficult algebraic problem, which is the section finding problem. So the problem is the following. Given a surface defined by a polynomial in three variables over a finite field, the goal is to find two univariate polynomials, ux and uy, such that the evaluation of s in ux and uy and t is equal to zero. And the principle of the algebraic surface cryptosystem is then to use the polynomial s as the public key and the section ux, uy as the secret key. So what are the main specificities of this construction? Is that it involves high-degree polynomials in only a few variables, and this permits to achieve very short keys, so which are linear in the logarithm of the expected security. Okay, so following these ideas, Akiyama, Goto, and Miyake proposed the algebraic surface cryptosystem last year, and this cryptosystem is resistant to all known attacks. So for the history of this system, Akiyama and Goto proposed before this three other cryptosystems based on this difficult algebraic problems. And these cryptosystems have been analyzed and attacked by Volok and Iwami. So the new algebraic surface cryptosystem is resistant to these attacks. So the security parameters of the algebraic surface cryptosystems are P, the cardinality of the ground field, D, the degree of the secret section. So D will be highly correlated to the size of the secret key. There is also W, which is the degree in X and Y of the polynomial S defining the public surface. And this value will be related to the size of the public key. So in this work, we propose a new algebraic attack on the algebraic surface cryptosystem, which is based on tools from computer algebra, so mainly Grobner basis computations and decomposition of IDLs. It's a message recovery attack, and surprisingly, it's often faster than the legal decryption algorithm. And for instance, it can break the system with recommended parameters in 0.05 seconds. And this experimental behavior is explained by complexity analysis, which showed that the attack is quasi-linear in the size of the secret key and polynomial in all the security parameters. Okay. So this is the outline of the talk. First, I will give a short description of the cryptosystem. Then I will present three variants of the attack, which are more and more efficient. So the level one attack is deterministic, is very high level, and gives a good view of the mechanisms involved in the attack. The level two attack is more efficient and is also deterministic, and the level three attack is the most efficient of these three variants, and it's probabilistic. Then we'll make a complexity analysis of the attack, and we'll show some experimental results. Okay, so first, this is a short description of the cryptosystem. So we already saw the three main security parameters, P, D, and W. So P is the cardinality of the ground field, D is the degree of the secret section, and W the degree of the public surface. But there are also three other public parameters, which are the support of some polynomials, so gamma F, gamma M, and gamma S. So we'll say that a polynomial has support gamma if all its monomials are in the set gamma. So gamma F, gamma M, and gamma S are sets of monomials. And the plain text is embedded in the coefficients of a polynomial with given support gamma M. So how do we encrypt? First, we choose at random three polynomials F, S0, and S1 with given support gamma F. And we choose two polynomials at random R0 and R1 with given support gamma S, so the same support as the public surface. And we construct two polynomials Fi, which are defined by Fi is equal to M plus Si times S plus Ri times F. And the ciphertext is this couple of polynomials. Then, how do we decrypt? So, to decrypt, we first compute the difference of the ciphertext F0 minus F1. And we evaluate it in the secret section, so in UX, UY, and T. So this gives a univariate polynomial H, which is the product of two univariate polynomials. So next, we want to recover the evaluation of F in the secret section. So we know the degree of this polynomial, because it can be deduced from public parameters. So we find a factor F tilde of the good degree of H of T. And we hope that this is exactly F evaluated in UX, UYT. Then we can compute the evaluation of the plain text in the secret section by computing the evaluation of F0 in the secret section modulo this polynomial F tilde. And finally, we know the support of M, we know the secret section, we know the evaluation of the plain text in the secret section. So we can substitute, and then we can obtain a linear system whose solutions are the coefficients of the plain text. So we can recover the plain text. And finally, we verify with a MAC that the factor F tilde we chose at the second step is exactly the evaluation of F in the secret section. Okay, so the complexity of this algorithm is not completely clear, since, for instance, the second step, it's not clear how to recover a factor of the good degree if the security parameters are high, but in practice, it seems to work. Okay, so we can summarize the decryption algorithm in three steps. So first, a substitution step, when we need the secret key. Then the factorization step. And finally, a linear system to solve. So the main point of the attack is to try to get rid of the substitution step. And to do this, we will use a generalization of factorization, which is decomposition of ideals. So in practice, we consider the ideal generated by the difference of the plain of the ciphertext and by the polynomial S. And it can be seen that this ideal can be decomposed in an intersection of two prime ideals. So we want to compute this decomposition. So how to do this? First, we do a projection step. So we eliminate the variable x. So this can be done with standard tools like Gromner basis or resultants. This gives a bivariate polynomial Q, which is the product of two irreducible polynomials Q0 and Q1. And each of these factors corresponds to one of the ideals of the decomposition. So we can reconstruct the decomposition by adding to the initial ideal generated by F0 minus F1 and S each of the factors Q0 and Q1. And by looking at the degrees of these polynomials with respect to Y, we can select which one corresponds to the ideal generated by F and S. So now we have a description of the ideal generated by F and S, and this knowledge will allow us to manipulate implicitly the polynomial F. So the next step of the attack is the following. We consider the ideal J, the ideal J, generated by the ideal F and S, and the ciphertexts F0 and F1. So it can be seen that this ideal is exactly equal to the ideal generated by M, F, and S. So now we have a description of an ideal which contains the plain text M. So we want to use this to recover the plain text. And to do this, we will use the normal form, which is a tool from commutative algebra. So the normal form with respect to J, it's a linear application from the polynomial ring to itself, whose kernel is exactly the ideal J. And such a linear map can be computed when a Grobner basis of the ideal J is known. So how do we use this to recover the plain text? The support of the plain text is public. And we know that M belongs to the ideal J. So the normal form of M is equal to 0. But since the normal form is linear, we can compute the normal form of each monomial in the support of the plain text. And then this gives a linear system whose solutions are exactly the coefficients of the plain text. Okay, so putting all of this together, we get this algorithm. So first, we eliminate one variable. So we obtain this polynomial Q. We factor it. We select one of its irreducible factors with highest degree with respect to Y. Then we construct the ideal J generated by F0, F1, S, and Q0, and we compute a Grobner basis of it. Finally, we compute the normal form of all monomials in the support of the polynomial M, and we solve the following linear system, which gives the coefficients of the plain text. So this attack can be straightforwardly implemented in a computer algebra system like Magma. And for instance, this is the code corresponding to the complete to this attack, so this complete level 1 attack. And for instance, Akiyama Goto and Miyake proposed a toy example of the algebraic surface cryptosystem. And on this toy example, this attack can retrieve the plain text in 2 minutes. So this is already an attack, but this attack cannot break the system with recommended parameters, so we need to find a way to make it more efficient. So to do this, we note that during the attack, all polynomials occurring have a very high degree in T and very low degree in X and Y. So it is natural to try to compute in the field of fractions with respect to T. So that polynomials occurring will have a low degree. So we can try to do the attack in this new setting. But there is a problem. When we consider the ideal J, this ideal is generated by three equations, independent equations, and the polynomial ring has only two variables. So there is an invertible element in the ideal, and this ideal J gives no information about the plain text. So to solve this problem, we have to add a degree of liberty, and this is done by adding a new variable to the ideal. So we consider now the ideal J prime, generated by the ideal F and S, and F0 plus Z and F1 plus Z. And this ideal is exactly the ideal generated by M plus Z, F and S. So now, we can do exactly the same thing. We compute the Grobner basis, of this ideal J prime. Then we compute all the normal form of all monomials in the support of M plus Z. This gives a linear system. We solve this linear system. We recover the coefficients of M plus Z, and then we deduce from it the coefficients of the plain text. Okay, and using this trick allows to speed up the attack. So now the toy example is broken in only 74 seconds. Okay. But we can make another observation, which is that during the level 2 attack, the coefficients, so in the fields of fractions with respect to t, are very small in the input of the algorithm. They are small in the output of the algorithm, but they are, as I say, could be very big during intermediate computations, and for instance, during the Gromov basis computations. So this is a classical problem in computer algebra, and the classical solution is to use a multimodular approach. So how to do this? Instead of computing in the field of fraction with respect to t, we compute in the finite field, which is the quotient of the polynomial ring fp of t, by an irreducible polynomial pl. So this way, we know that the degree of the intermediate coefficients will be bounded by the degree of pl. So we can do exactly the level 2 attack in this new setting, and this permits to roll over m modulo the irreducible polynomial pl. But if you choose several irreducible polynomials pl such that the degree of their product is greater than the degree of the plain text with respect to t, then we can reconstruct the plain text by using the Chinese remainder theorem. Okay. And by using this technique, we can increase the efficiency of the level 2 attack. And now the Terry example is broken in 0.05 seconds. So putting all these steps together, this is the complete algorithm for the level 3 attack. So first, we choose a set of irreducible polynomials such that the sum of their degrees is greater than the degree in T of the plain text, M. Then, for each of these polynomials, we consider the finite field, which is the quotient of the polynomial ring in T by the irreducible polynomial PL. We eliminate the variable X here by computing a resultant. Then we factor this polynomial. We select a polynomial with highest degree with respect to y. Then we construct the ideal j prime generated by f0 plus z, f1 plus z, s, and q0. Then, once we have a Gromov basis of this ideal, we compute the normal form of all monomials in the support of m plus z. And then we solve the linear system. We retrieve m modulo this polynomial pl. And finally, we use the Chinese remainder theorem to reconstruct the plain text. So what is the complexity of this algorithm? So the number of loops is equal to the number of polynomials considered. So here, c is a constant chosen by the attacker. For each of the polynomials, we have to compute one resultant. We have to factor it. So this is done with the Cantor's ascendance algorithm. Then you have to perform one Gromov basis computations. So here we use the algorithms F4 or F5. So this complexity is obtained by estimating the degree of regularity of the ideal by using the Macaulay bound. And then we have to use the Chinese remainder theorem to reconstruct the plain text. So together, the total binary complexity of the level 3 attack is upper bounded by this value, which is soft O of D times W to the 7 times log P. And the main observation is that this quantity is quasi-linear in the size of the secret key. So now we have a theoretical estimation of the complexity of the attack. We can go into experimental results. So here, in this table, we compare the times of the level 2 attack when P and D increase. So the first line is represents the recommended parameters. So in this, with these parameters, the attack time is 0.05 seconds. And we see that when D increases, then the total time of the attack increases linearly with D, as expected. And we can see that this is not specific to the characteristic 2, it's the attack is also efficient when P is large. So we saw in the complexity analysis that the complexity was polynomial with degree 7 with respect to W. So we can try to increase W instead. And by doing this, we see that the most expensive step of the attack becomes the Grandmal basis computations, which is as expected by the complexity analysis. And we see that even when W is big, the attack remains practical, even just a few hours to recover the plain text. So in conclusion, we gave a description of the algebraic structure behind the algebraic surface crypto system. And this allowed us to perform an algebraic cryptanalysis of the crypto system by using tools from computer algebra, so mainly Grandmal basis, resultants, efficient Chinese remainder theorem, or decomposition of ideals. And this attack can break the recommended parameters in 0.05 seconds. For the perspective, this attack is not an algorithm to solve the section finding problem. We just showed how to avoid to solve it in the context of the algebraic surface crypto system. So we believe that the section finding problem could be an alternative to the classical polynomial system solving for multivariate cryptography. So thank you very much for your attention.